The victim had looked ill for days, off color, wilted, almost wasting away. Food, water, medicine, nothing seemed to help. Everything got worse and worse until finally, the victim died. It was clear that a crime had been committed, but the perpetrator is unknown. Time to call Sherrie Smith, plant detective. Sherrie is what you might call a crime scene investigator in the field. She is the state plant pathologist for the Plant Health Clinic at the University of Arkansas. Do your soybeans have spots? Is your wisteria withering? Do you have holes in your hostas? Then it could be time to contact Sherrie.
We look at fungal diseases, bacterial diseases, and viruses. Often we get plants that have insect infestations due to the fact the plant's stressed, because stressed plants send out signals that actually draw insects to them, kind of like fish thrashing around in the water draw sharks.
When the Plant Health Clinic receives a case, it is first taken to the plant morgue, where it's laid out on the table. The plant body is examined and checked for obvious wounds: brown or mutilated leaves, colorful spots, or lumps on the roots. After that, Sherrie heads to the microscope to help make a diagnosis.
This is important because, for instance, Arkansas economy depends heavily on agriculture. I'll diagnose a disease and make a recommendation on how to control the disease.
Every year, Sherrie receives thousands of victims from all over the state and beyond. Many samples come from commercial crops grown by farmers in Arkansas or plants in greenhouses for commercial sale. Sometimes, however, an unusual case will pop up. Like humans, plants are vulnerable to numerous assaults: malnutrition, viruses, fungus, bacteria, insects, drought, and poisons. It's up to Sherrie to determine the real culprit.
The best part of my job is talking to people every day and helping them with their plant problems. There's always something exciting going on. It's like a puzzle or a mystery. And every day you solve a mystery. Some of them are easy to solve and some of them aren't, but I really like that aspect of my job.
Once she has completed her investigation, Sherrie will file a report with the appropriate authorities, usually the people who have sent her the victim's body. She will name the culprit, and the plant owners can take steps towards putting the criminal behind bars.